Repeat after me. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this investigation? So help you God. Thank you. Please be seated. Alam niyo po, Director, hindi naman sa nagbibigay kami ng bintang, pero nakakasira po ito sa imahe, hindi lamang ng NBI, kung hindi magiging ang ating pamahalaan ay naapektuhan at kasama na ho lahat tayo rito kung bakit merong isang preso na nakakulong, makatapos ay nakakalabas, nakakapamasyal, nakarating pa sa amin sa Tagaytay, kasama ang mga gwardiya ng NBI, high profile detainee, at di umano ay marami pang ibang mga ganitong pangyayari. Nanganak-nganak na rin tong problema, at maging sa mga ulat na natanggap nitong committee, maging yun na imbestigahan ni Senator De La Rosa, yung Digamo case, yung si Marvin Miranda, ay nakakalabas din daw. Nakakalabas din daw ng NBI facilities kahit talagang nakapiit siya doon. So gusto natin malaman dito, Director, kung paano po ito nangyayari na kahit walang court order, kahit walang justification, kahit walang dahilan, medical man o hindi, ay nakakapunta ng Tagaytay, Subic, Calatagan sa Batangas, at maging sa mga high-class restaurants dito sa Metro Manila, ang isang high-profile detainee. We have several footages to show. I'm not sure if the committee is ready now. Meron ba kayo? Comsec? So, kung hindi pa ready? Can we show the... But before that, we'd like to papasukin muna sila. Papasukin muna sila and then recognize them, Comsec, and then administer the oath accordingly. Siguraduhin nyo lang tama yung inuupuan nyo. I understand there are lawyers here present representing some of the accused. So you are allowed to give advice. You will not be allowed to speak before this committee. You are allowed to give advice to your client, giving them appropriate counsel as part of their constitutional rights. Sa likuran lang kayo, bubulong lang kayo doon. But do not interrupt the proceedings of this committee. Ba't yung isa nakabaliktad yung pangalan? Comsec, huwag ka na sigurong umalis para dire-diretso tayo. Identify them. As you are called, please rise because we will administer the oath. Go ahead, Comsec.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. With us for the Jadera case, we have Mr. Jose Adrian Jadera. Kindly stand, please, sir.
Tumayo ka lang, tumayo ka lang.
Mr. Randy Godoy. Mr. Eric Loreto. Mr. Arnel Ganzon. Mr. King Martin. Ms. Diana Veloso. And Mr. Pepe Piedad Jr.
Can you administer the oath?
Tumayo yes, ka rin. Mr. Chairman. Kindly raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth in this proceeding? The oath has been administered, Mr. Chair.
Maraming salamat. Please be seated. So bago ko pasalitain si Director De Lemos, pakita nga natin itong maigsing video presentation na ito. If you can annotate. Ito ba yung sa Makati restaurant? Wala bang sounds yan? That's a CCTV, walang sound. O sino to nakikita? Ayan si Jare, Dadera. yung nakagulat sa ating mga kababayan, lumabas naman ito sa ilang pahayagan at sa balita, paano nakakalabas ang isang high-profile detainee sa piitan ng National Bureau of Investigation kahit walang order ang husgado. This committee will allow you to have your introductory statement because we will be asking you later on succeeding questions. So, pwede nyo lang patayin yan, nakaka-distract. Go ahead, Attorney De Lemos.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. Good afternoon, Senator De La Rosa. I have no opening statement. We are ready to answer questions. First, it is very unfortunate that this incident happened, but you would like to emphasize that there are only two instances where detainees are allowed under the practice and procedure of the NBI. It's only upon court order, and secondly, on emergency medical cases. And in these two instances, the incident transpired without the requisite court order and medical emergency medical justification for bringing out the detainee.
Can you repeat that? There was no court order
and there is no medical emergency to justify bringing out the detainee from the facility. All of these are under the watch of our SMS, the Security Management section of the NBI. To put in proper context, the unit is under the supervision of our General Services Division under the HRMS, the Human Resource Management Service, and under the Deputy Director for Administration. On that night of June 20, we received an information that detainee was out of the facility. And our Assistant Director for Regional Operations authorized an operation for the arrest and detention of the violators. And in that same night, when they returned, the marked vehicle returned to the premises of the NBI in Taft Avenue, all of them were arrested. The security supervisor in the person of Randy Godoy, five other job order security officers, and subject Dera. Thereafter, they were presented on inquest and they're now in detention. As a matter of corrective measure on the part of the NBI, we charged them before the prosecutor's office. We relieved the chief of our SMS. We ordered for the investigation of the whole incident by our TIFAID and the NCR. We also ordered our internal investigation division to conduct an investigation. We instituted a new chief in the SMS and another executive officer. We also exerted efforts to have Dera transferred to the facility where he should be. And with the assistance of the Supreme Court Administrator, Justice Raul Villanueva, we were able to secure a court order transferring him to the Muntinlupa City Jail.
All of them or just Mr.
Only for Mr.
Dera?
Dera, Mr. Chair. We also transferred the supervision of our SMS from our administrative services to our investigative, to our intelligence service. And we have also directed the intelligence service to constitute a TWG to review the whole processes in the SMS. So these are the SWIFT.
You transferred SMS to be detailed under the supervision of the intelligence service, and the intelligence service will review the process.
We have constituted a TWG to review the whole process of the security management of our detention facility. From the general, from the administrative service, because your honors, Mr. Chair, the NBI has two major services, the investigative service under Deputy Yap, and investigative service under Deputy Yap, and the administrative service under Deputy Pagatpat. So from the administrative service, we transferred the management of our security management section under the intelligence service under Deputy Yap. And we are also asking, we have also requested the help of the court administrator that all of our detainees who have pending cases before the courts should be transferred to the city jails where the cases are pending. Because as of the moment, we have detainees who are ready for commitment, but we have difficulty transferring them to their different city jails. And with this arrangement, we hope to reduce the number of detainees in the NBI, which is designed for only for a temporary lockup, as a temporary lockup for persons under investigation, to 50%. And in the meantime also, because of the pending construction and demolition of the building in Taft, we need to transfer the whole detention facility to Bucor. And we have signed a memorandum of agreement with Bucor Director Katapang. And the same may be occupied by July 16. And for the information of the committee, your honors, the ideal capacity of the NBI jail is only 50 detainees. And this 50 detainees has been exceeded the facility. We have, as of the moment, around 90 detainees, because we have transferred 12 of them yesterday in the Bureau of Immigration.
But before you proceed, Director, let us revert back to the original reason why we are here. Itong si Dera, tatanungin din kita, kung ito ba ay nalipat na sa Bucor ngayon, hindi kaya maulit din na yung lalabas din siya. Yun din yung personalities involved. So babalik tayo ron. Tapos siguro, tatanungin ko na rin, before you proceed, Director, tatanungin ko rin to si Mr. Jad Dera. Masagot ka, alisin mo yung maskara mo. Ilang beses ka na nakaalis-alis sa NBI? Mayores ka, di ba? Mayor. You open the mic. Comsec, huwag kang matakot lumapit. Kahit mababait naman yan eh. Ilang beses ka nang palabas-labas? Tama itong sinabi ko na Kalatagan, Subic, nagtagaytay ka, Metro Manila, parang it's more fun in the Philippines yung ginawa mo. Ilang beses ka na monthly ka ba, lumalabas, weekly?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Ilang beses?
Mga apat lang po.
Nagbabayad ka?
Yung iba po kasi nagdaan po kami sa ospital, nagpa-check up po ako.
Wala ka namang medical reason na inaprobahan ng husgado. Tutuloy mo yan mamaya. So nagtanong ko, nagbayad ka ba?
Hindi po.
Wala kang binabayaran?
Wala po.
So yung binabanggit mo, Director De Lemos, ito na yung reaction after this incident.
Yes, sir. Those were the corrective actions.
So prior to this incident, wala po kayong, kasi apat na raw eh. Naka-apat na siya eh. Yung tatlo, walang balita na wala tayong intelligence report na may tatlong. Jad, ano yung natatandaan mo ba kung kailan kayo yung unang tatlo mo? Anong taon?
Yung pinakauna ko po yung sa Maddox po, yung may order po ako.
Anong year yon? Anong petsa kung natatandaan mo?
December 10, 2021 po.
2021. COVID pa. Kalabas ka, saan nagpunta? Tagaytay?
Sa Manila Japan? Doctors po.
Ah, Manila Doctors. Pangalawa, ano?
Pangalawa po, Your Honor, dumaan po muna sa infant para sa puso ko po. Tapos,
ano infant? Infant,
infant hospital po.
So may court order yon?
Wala po, Your Honor.
Wala rin, no. Ay, yung pangatlo, tumaan muna sa infant. Tapos ibig sabihin, pagkatapos ng infant, may pinuntahan ka pang iba.
Kumain po muna. Tapos balik na po sa okay. NBI po.
Okay. Kailan yung kalatagan?
Hindi ko na po matandaan, Your Honor.
Paano hindi matandaan? Malayo-layo yun. Yung pangatlo, kailan yun?
Yung Father's Day po.
Ito lang?
Opo.
2020, kailan ba? Father's Day, June?
Ito pong June po.
June 15. So, nung Father's Day, June 15, tapos after one week, June 20, June 21, lumabas ka uli.
Yung pinakahuli po, ito na po yung sa Makati po.
Oho. So, Director, itong June, nakadalawa siya. So, yung una niyan June, Father's Day, wala hong report na lumabas siya. Para yung binabanggit natin na rectification ay nagawa noong after Father's Day, wala.
Sir, it was only after the arrest that this unauthorized bringing out of the detainee came to the attention of the top management of the NBI.
Kasi po, nakakalimutan na niya, hindi na niya matandaan. Hindi mo na matandaan, babalikan kita, hindi mo na matandaan ang kalatagan. Ang subik, hindi mo na rin matandaan?
Hindi ko po alam yung subik po, Your Honor.
Ah, hindi ka nagpunta ng subik po? Tagaytay?
Nang may tinransfer po sa Cavite, sumama po ako.
Anong sabi sumama ka? Nakisabay ka? Gano? Joyride?
Opo.
So tinransfer sa Cavite, sumama ka kasi siguro fresh air, gano'n. So, are you aware of that, Director? Nakisakay? May bakante pa sigurong upuan. Ban? Siguro, ban? Sinakyan?
Yes po.
Are you aware of that?
I was never informed about that, Mr. Chair.
Kailan yon, Jad, yung Tagaytay visit mo?
Nung may tinransfer po na detainee po, sumama po.
Taon na to?
Yes po.
Ayan. Siguro mga Marso, Pebrero?
Siguro po mga March po.
Ayun, March. So March, lumabas siya, nag-joyride. Wala, hindi kayo na-inform, Director. June 15, nagpunta ng infant. Pagkatapos, tama ba infant? Tapos nag-restaurant. Sa opo. Restaurant yon?
Sa Makati po.
Ayun. Ito rin yung mga kasama mo?
Opo. Ayun. Yes po.
Sa Tagaytay sila rin?
Yes po.
Ayun. Nag-restaurant kayo sa Tagaytay? Bulalo?
Sa Bulaluan po yun.
Oh, so nag-bulalo pa. Ha? Baka nagkatabi pa tayo ron. Ah, Director, so hindi pala ito yung una. Pangatlo. Sa nare-recall niya, pangatlo. Pero baka meron pa siyang hindi natatandaan na pangyayari. So, your corrective mode and procedures done after this came about because it was highlighted by the media, lumabas na Pero kung hindi siguro na nalabas ito yung mga CCTV, lahat, eh baka tuloy-tuloy pa ito, makamanood ka pa ng FIBA basketball sa Ugos. So, ang kailangan po malaman ng committee ito, Director, no offense, ay hindi yung nagawa pagkatapos niyang gawin itong huli, kung hindi yung gagawin pa para ma-institutionalize na hindi na maulit. Kasi meron ako mga report dito with permission of Senator De La Rosa, yung isa sa mga suspect doon sa Digamo assassination, lumalabas din. Lumalabas din ng kulungan at hindi ko alam kung saan nagpupunta naman ito. Kaya inimbita natin dito yung kanina, lahat yung mga kabataan tigat Dugumaguete nandito. Marvin Miranda, palabas-labas din. Kilala mo ba yung Jared?
Kilala ko po.
So, kasabay kayo lumalabas?
Hindi ko po alam yan, ganyan po.
Pero, nababalitaan mo siya, palabas-labas din?
Hindi naman po, dahil po nakaiwalay po siya.
Ah, so hindi mo nakikita siya araw-araw?
Hindi naman po.
Director, anything to add before I turn this over to Senator De La Rosa?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Repeat your introductory statement as I mentioned a while ago.
Mr. Chair, as I was saying, all of this came to light only after we arrested Jedera on June 20 of 2023. And as much as you would want to go deeper into prosecuting all of those responsible for the infractions, I was informed as of late that no sworn statements were taken. No sworn statements were taken for us to charge persons responsible for bringing out without authority Dera out of the facility. All of these were in a form of...
The reason is because the PAU refused to assist. Pero FBI is also authorized to administer oaths.
Yes, Mr. Chair, but we perform different roles. We are the investigators and we cannot be lawyers for our suspects. And the practice is that we should give them lawyers of their own choice. And the only agency that we have requested for this in all our investigations were the lawyers from PAU. But in this instance, our agents informed us that PAU would not want to assist suspects under investigation. These
the presence of private attorneys behind them.
Yes, Mr. Chair, and the difficulty being encountered by our investigators is that when asked to give their sworn statements, the investigators would inform us that at the moment, these persons are not willing to give their sworn statements.
But just the same, the Department of Justice can proceed. Diba?
Sir.
I'll let you answer later on.
Yes, sir. But without sworn statements to form part as evidence of the charge that the NBI will be taking, it is very difficult to proceed with the charges before the prosecutor's office. We cannot possibly charge them on the basis of our interrogation and tactical questionings.
But everything that transpired was in flagrante delicto.
That is a different case, Your Honor, because they were charged for that.
Alin yung sinasabi mo ngayon na?
Ay yung paglabas-labas nung apat na beses, hindi po namin na-charge yun. Pero nung nahuli sa akto, that very same day they were charged for bribery, corruption, 1319.
He's under oath. He just admitted that he went out four times. The records of these proceedings can be used against him.
Perhaps After the proceedings, Your Honor, we will study on how we can utilize the statements given before this committee.